Fine students, how are you all? Hope you are fine with the grace of the Almighty God. So students, as you know that we have already started the revisions. So today we will revise with the chapter number 3 of the social and political life, and our topic of the chapter is roles and functions of a government. So before we start, what we are going to learn in this chapter is about the meaning and the need of the government. Okay, the meaning and the need of the government we will study. The levels of the government we will study. Okay. Then also we will come to know the decision making and the participations of the people. Okay. Then various forms of the government we will study. Then various, now let's get started in the first part. Okay. In the first part, you can see here that in a class, a class teacher plays an important role in laying down the rules and monitoring that the rules are followed, and followed the punishing those who fail to obey the rules and the resolving the conflicts among the students. A teacher performs all these functions to ensure the smooth functioning of the class. Now you see, in a class, a class teacher has the duty. What duty he or she has got is that in order to look after the smooth functioning of the class, if any students, if you say that does naughtiness, then what is the duty of the class teacher? They give the punishment. Okay. So in the same way, and why does he or she does in this way? Because in order to maintain the rules and regulation, the smooth functioning of the class. In the same way, as the class teacher has got various duties here. Okay, in the same way, the class teacher has got the duties here. The government also performs a variety of functions, and why does he does so? In order to smooth functioning of the country's laws. It makes the laws, monitor the implementation of the laws, punishes those who do not obey the laws. Okay, the government looks after that who is not following the laws and to whom to punish for the not maintaining and obeying the rules and regulation of this country. Okay, in the particular class, if you take example, the government is looking after that to whom to punish. Okay, like for example, in a particular country, if you give example, the government is always putting eye, and for that reason the police is there, court is there, right? Now governments and meaning and the need, if you say what is the need of the government, okay, what is the functions of the government? A government is always responsible, you know, a government is a group of the people who is responsible for the managing the policies, actions and affairs of the country or the state. In India, the government acts on the behalf of the citizens of the country to ensure the welfare for the good functioning of the citizen. A government performs variety of functions in the country or the state. Okay, and some of the means functions, okay, are that is mentioned in the page number 208, you can see, is that to provide the various facilities. Okay, it provides the various facilities and the services, such as the healthcare services, education, employment, postal services. Like for example, if you say about education services, then you can know that there are government schools are there. Yes, government schools are there. Okay, so in the government school, the government is giving the salary in order to educate the children. Okay, so that fulfills the requirements of the pupil. To manage and fairly distribute the resources of the country among the people. Okay, it looks after that how to manage the resources, how to, you know, means equally manage the resources and how to distribute the resources among the people in the equally way. To provide the relief materials to the victims and the natural disasters. Like for example, if there is a flood, then the government will provide the food, then also shelter, then to enforce the laws and maintain the law order in the country. It will look if and laws and order is there, it will always enforce new law and it will maintain the new laws and regulations in the country. To safeguard the border of the country from the foreign attack, it will always be safeguarding, okay, the country from the foreign attack. Like for example, the Bangladesh, the Pakistan border, the China border, there you can find the BSF, Border Security Force. They are always helping us. They are always protecting us from the enemies. okay, to maintain the friendly relation. Cordial means friendly. You can write with the pencil also. Cordial means friendly, okay? The to maintain the friendly relation of the countries with the other nation to promote the exchange of the good and then services and the ideas. Okay, that if they will maintain the friendly relation with the country, then they can sell their things, they can buy the things from the other. Okay, that is import and export they can do. Okay, then next you see that levels of the government. In the levels of the government, we will see that a government functions on the different levels. Okay, in India, the government functions on the three levels, that is national or the central, state and the local government. Okay, then let us speak about the central government. The central government makes the laws for entire country. Okay, the central government makes the laws for entire country. It is based in the New Delhi. And why does the central government is based in? It is based in the New Delhi. The state government makes the laws for the state. It is usually located in the capital of the state. Lastly, the local government functions in the city, towns, and or the village. Okay. In the last week, if you speak, the local government sees in the city, the towns, or the villages. Like, for example, for the village requirements, they are setting up the Gaon Panchayat election, where the Gaon Buddha is selected. Okay, that is Panchayat. The Panch is Solno, the head of that particular village is selected, the Gaon Buddha. Then the head of the particular ward, that is municipal area, that is ward commissioner is being selected. Laws and the people. At each level of the governance, the government performs the function by making the enforcing law. For example, in order to ensure the safety of the people on the road, there is a law that people, okay, driving a car must wear their seat belts. You see, in order to protect the people, the government is also making laws for protect their lives, secure their lives. Okay, like for example, in here it is given. I like to give a personal example is that while riding bikes, okay, the government has made laws that the person should wear what? Helmet. Okay, the person should wear helmet. Like while riding scooty also, you must wear helmet. If any person is found without helmet, then what? The government takes fines. And it is about nearly 3,000 rupees. So people are what? They are scared in order to pay the fines and they are wearing the helmet as means of to make the people to obey this law. Anybody caught violating the law is penalized. Okay, they are charged. The enforcement of the law is important, as without the enforcement of the laws would not be much use. Okay, there should be person who looks after the laws. The people of the country also play a very important role in enforcement of the laws, to look after the laws. If the citizens of the country feel that the particular law is not being followed, okay, they are entitled to go to the court. For example, the law of the country prohibits discrimination on the basis of the caste, then class or gender. Thus, if the person is discriminated on these grounds, they can go to the court to seek justice. Means what? You see, what is written here, if any person, okay, if any person is not given any rights, if he goes to the police station, the police is not behaving with him or her properly, then he can move to the court and seek for justice. Okay, then he can move to the court and seek for justice. Next, forms of the government. Forms of the government, a government can be of different types, such as democracy and monarchy. In simple, if we say, first, the democracy is there. In the simple, I will say, it is the real power, you can say, where we, the general people, okay, where we, the general people, give our vote to the common, you can say, people, those whom we like. And who will give the vote? The person who is above 18 years of age. Okay, in democracy, we have the choice to whom we want to see the government. Okay, but in monarchy, we will not have any choice. Okay, like if king's son will be the what? Next king. In monarchy system, the king's son will be the next king. The king's daughter will be the next queen or the princess. okay, this is the monarchy system. In simple, in Hindi, we are saying that Raja ka beta hi Raja banega. Okay, where is in the democracy, which is not there. In democracy, what is there? You know, elections are being held. Anybody can become. Right now, among from you, in future, after 20 or 30 years, among from you only, maybe someone will be the prime minister, chief minister, governor, DC, deputy commissioner. Okay, so it happens only in democracy. But in monarchy, whatever the queen or the king wish for, okay, that only should become. Means rights are not given that much. Whatever the decision will be taken in the monarchy, you cannot go against it. You have to follow it. Okay? Then, but in the democracy, the people has the right. If they feel that their right is being violated. If someone say someone that you are black, your language is not proper, what type of language you are speaking, then he can report to this police station. Okay? So democracy and the monarchy is over. Universal adult franchise will be. Okay? Universal adult franchise in the page number 209, we can see. What do you mean by the universal adult franchise? In order to vote, okay, you need your right. However, the country cannot call its democracy if there is no vote is there. And in order to vote, we need what? The people support. And who will, which, what kind of people will support? Are the children will give the vote? No. The citizens of the India, whose age is above 18 years of age, can vote and he can enjoy or she can enjoy the rights. This is called universal adult franchise. In India, it was long struggle, you know, of the especially of Mahatma Gandhi, okay, and other nationalists, the national supporter like Jawaharlal Nehru, Bipin Chandra Pal, Subhash Chandra Bose, okay, this all has played very important role. There are numerous people are there. From Assam also, many people was there who has fought in order to rule the India, in order to get back their rule in the hand. They don't want it to be ruled by someone who came from outside. During the British rule, the British discouraged the participation of the Indians in the governance of the country. They did not like that if any Indian people will become the government. Only the man with the wealth, if you are very rich, okay, then you can have your election. Then you can go and vote someone. If you are very rich or if you are very much educated, then only you can go. Whereas in the women, the poor and the people who had no property were not allowed to cast their vote. When India attained independence, the right to vote was extended to the all the sections of the society. Means everybody can give the vote. Let us see the case study. Okay, the case study. Today in some most democracies, women enjoy the right to vote in elections. However, women across the world has to fight extensively to gain their right to vote. In earlier days, the women were considered to be the inferior to men and capable of only taking care of the children at home rather than contributing to the society as full citizens. However, some women challenged this discrimination and demanded the right to vote for the women in the form of the women's suffrage movement. So you see, what is women's suffrage movement? When the women challenged the discrimination that they wanted to be treated fairly as the men do, okay? They wanted to be treated fairly as the men do. This thing only is demand for the right to vote. This was known as the women's suffrage movement. The woman who demanded the right to vote was, woman came to be known as the suffragettes. The women's suffrage movement reached its highest peak during the First World War. Okay, during the war, men were away on the battlefields. The man was not there. As a result, women had to be called to take the responsibility of the work, which was considered to be fit for just for men. You see, the women fought the war. Okay, the women fought the war. When the people found that the women were doing their trying their level best in organizing all the war, Then they felt sorry about it, that why did not we allow this many days to, means we neglected the women. They were feeling sorry out of it, that why they have been doing discrimination with the women. As a result, the movement for the rights gained the strength and the women were granted the right to vote. In the USA, the women got the right to vote in 1920, while in the United Kingdom, the right was extended in 1928. Okay, now you must think and you must that what was the women's suffrage movement? How did the women's suffrage movement reach in the highest during the First World War? Could the women's suffrage movement achieve its goal? Justify your answer well. You have to think about it, okay? So, you see, beyond the borders, New Zealand was one of the first countries to allow women to vote in election. So just keep in mind. Then, just round up, you can see here. Till the time is there, you can see the roundup here. Okay, the roundup you can see here. What is written in the roundup? Government. What does the government do? It manages the policy, actions, and looks after the affairs, whatever goes in the country. Okay, then there are types of government. Then the levels of government is there. I told there are two types, and the levels of the government is there. In the types of government, there are democracy and monarchy system are there. As I told, what is democracy and monarchy? The system of vote, where you can vote and you can elect, okay, that to whom you want to see the prime minister, chief minister, okay, this all system is called what? Democracy, okay, this all system are called what? Democracy. But levels in the India, there are central, state and local level. Like for example, okay, the state, our honorable chief minister Dr. Hemanta Biswa Sarma is the state government, while Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi is the central minister or central government. Okay, so I hope the students, I have given all the question answers there. If you have doubt or something, then you can ask me in the next class. Okay, so next class I'll be starting with the revision of chapter 4. Then till and there, take care. Thank you. Bye bye, everyone.